Kevin Bacon. You have to pretend you're an actual hero or else Christmas is doomed.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for some of the best supporting characters in the MCU. Some minor plot spoilers may be ahead.
Have you been listening this whole time?
Hi, Happy. Not by choice.
Number 10, John Walker.
I am Captain America.
There's a classic expression that goes, heavy is the head that wears the crown. In regards to the MCU, you could probably also say that heavy is the arm that wields the shield. After all, when John Walker took on the mantle of Captain America, he was nobody's favorite.
Okay. Look, I think we got off on the wrong foot.
Fans quickly rejected him, and eventually the Marvel Universe themselves rejected him too. Despite the rocky start, it became clear that John didn't necessarily deserve all of that hate. He was a skilled soldier with a genuine desire to do good. In fact, he later helped Falcon and Winter Soldier turn the tides against the Flag Smashers. His stint as Captain America might not have gone as planned, but maybe he'll get his due as the U.S. agent.
We're gonna need a U.S. agent.
Number 9, Eric Selvig.
Still don't think you're the God of Thunder, but you ought to be.
This astrophysicist is one of the brightest minds in the MCU. In fact, Loki possessed Eric during the Avengers so that he could make a portal for the Chitarian army to use to invade Earth.
It's too late! You can't stop now. He wants to show us something! A new universe.
Yeah, we know, that's not actually a good thing, but hey, if a literal god thinks you're smart enough to pull that off, who are we to judge? And even though Eric fell under Loki's mind control, he was eventually able to snap out of it long enough to help shut the portal down. Who knows how dire things could have gotten for Earth if he hadn't done that? He might not have superpowers or a fancy suit of armor, but Eric Selvig might be a hero in his own right.
There's nothing more reassuring than realizing that the world is crazier than you are.
Number 8, Scarlet Scarab.
You turned Mark's life into a waking nightmare. Why would I ever sign up for that?
She might not be a character with a vast amount of lore, but that doesn't mean we don't want to see more of her in the MCU. Layla Abdallah El-Fowley is Mark Spector's somewhat estranged wife, but she's been doing just fine on her own. With the help of the Egyptian goddess Tararet, Layla became her own hero known as the Scarlet Scarab.
I would be delighted to accept you as my avatar.
It's not just the range of super cool powers she has that we want to see more of. Her journey is also equally compelling. Despite currently only having appeared in Moon Knight, she's become a very well-rounded character. We're not sure where she may land next, but there's got to be more room for a Scarlet Scarab somewhere.
Is this a superhero, Mosreya?
Oh. Number 7, Kraglin.
Howdy there, you freaking creep.
Not many side characters have managed to undergo as much of a character arc as Kraglin has. When he started off in the MCU with the first Guardians movie, he was just a member of Yondu's Ravager crew. But by the third Guardians movie, he essentially became part of the family.
Kraglin.
Oh, hey, Pete.
We need to save Nebula, Mantis, and Drax, and we need your help.
Me?
Who doesn't love a good underdog story? He might not look like one of the galaxy's most premier protectors, especially with that mohawk, but he's proven to be one nonetheless. We don't know what's in store for the future of the Guardian of the Galaxy's corner of the MCU, but we really hope it can evolve more Kraglin.
Thanks. Captain.
Number 6, Luis. This guy was the heart and soul of the first two Ant-Man movies. Sorry, but you really can't convince us otherwise.
Hey, how's your girl, man?
She left me.
Oh.
Yeah, my mom died, too. And my dad got deported. But I got the van.
Luis was Scott Lang's former cellmate and close friend. When Scott became Ant-Man, Luis would be a pivotal part of his crew. He may be mostly comic relief, but there is no shame in that, especially if you're so good at it.
So I'm at this art museum with my cousin Ignacio, right? And there was this like abstract expressionism exhibit. But you know me, I'm more like a neo-cubist kind of guy, right? But there was this one Rothko that was sublime, bro.
This is a guy who could make anything sound interesting with his narration skills. We're not going to say that Luis' absence was the reason Quantumania flopped, but it definitely didn't help. If the MCU really wants to get back on track, then we need that 6-episode Marvel Spotlight Luis spinoff. Okay, maybe not, but just put him somewhere. pretty please?
That fancy raspberry filling represents the company's rent, and we're days away from going out of business. Oh!
Out of business.
Days away?
Damn truth, sir!
Number 5, Talos.
My people lived as refugees on Torfa. Homeless ever since we resisted Kree rule.
Talos might not look like a good guy at first, but once you get past his green exterior, you see that he means well. This Skrull has been helping keep Earth safe for years. Nick Fury even trusted him enough to have him masquerade as him when he was off-world.
That costume, the craftsmanship and that, I mean, this is just embarrassing for a shapeshifter.
Talos would unfortunately die during Secret Invasion fighting off the Skrull resistance, but his efforts were not forgotten. Despite losing his home planet and being essentially forced into hiding, Talos never wished harm on humanity and actively protected it. And for that, the MCU owes a debt of gratitude to him.
We just have to keep showing them who we are.
Number 4, Okoye.
When you said we are going to open Wakanda to the rest of the world, this is not what I imagined.
And what did you imagine?
The Olympics.
Okoye is one of Wakanda's best defenses against invaders, really only second to the Black Panther. There's not many other people who are as loyal to Wakanda as her, and that unwavering devotion to her nation hasn't gone unrecognized.
You are not fit to be a king!
As part of the highly skilled and highly deadly Dora Milaje, you know she only means business. Okoye hasn't just stuck to Wakanda though. She's ventured out on occasion to help out against bigger problems. This most notably includes assisting the Avengers in their fight against the evil Thanos. She's shown her worth plenty of times already, but we hope we won't have to wait long to see her being a badass warrior again.
Take another step closer, and I'll kill you all.
Number 3, Happy Hogan. He's the best bodyguard Tony Stark has ever had for a reason. Happy Hogan isn't just any character.
I just feel so dumb. I didn't realize you were miserable.
He's someone who's been around since the start of the MCU with the very first Iron Man movie. He's aided Iron Man numerous times and has also stepped up in the wake of his death too. After Endgame, he became an important part of Peter Parker's life and helped him out of plenty of binds.
What?
Nothing. You take care of the suit. I'll take care of the music.
Happy is someone you can count on, and that goes a long way in this universe. He might not be someone who can fight Thanos, but if you need something, Happy Hogan is always happy to help.
I'm gonna get you all the cheeseburgers you want.
Number 2, Mantis.
Maybe if we gave Peter a really wonderful Christmas gift, it would make him happy.
Well, we could give him those Zarg nuts, except you ate them all.
Get over the Zarg nuts!
Mantis really only has a few very specific superpowers, but when she gets to work, she delivers amazing results. This Guardian of the Galaxy, who also happens to be Star-Lord's half-sister, has faced all kinds of enormous threats. She's helped stop the High Evolutionary, and also temporarily held back forces like Eagle and Thanos. That's right. The Avengers almost defeated Thanos in Infinity War thanks to Mantis using her powers to put him to sleep. If Mantis is able to keep the Mad Titan subdued, even temporarily, that's a win on its own.
He makes us laugh and he loves us. How is that a liability?
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Number 1, Wong.
And you are?
Wong.
Wong. Just Wong?
Wong has reached many milestones throughout the MCU. Going from Doctor Strange's unofficial sidekick, he's now gotten bumped up to becoming the Sorcerer Supreme. If you ask us, that's got to be the promotion of a lifetime. But while he's gained that impressive accolade, fans can't help but want more Wong.
My name is Wong.
I know, sir. I'm a huge fan.
Do you have the rings?
He'll most likely be in the third Doctor Strange movie, but there's no reason he can't pop up in other places like how he did in Shang-Chi and She-Hulk. Benedict Wong himself has even expressed interest in the character getting his own spin-off series. It's uncertain if something like that will ever be in the work, but hopefully Marvel can work their magic sometime soon.
Is that everyone?
Like you wanted more?
Is there an underrated MCU character we missed? Let us know in the comments down below.
For Wakanda.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 best characters in the MCU.
Just like Buddha.
Budapest all over again.
You and I remember Budapest very differently.
For this list, we're looking at the most intriguing and dynamic characters of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Which MCU hero or villain tops your list? Share with us in the comments below. Number 10, Thanos. The Mad Titan shocked audience members everywhere by being one of the only MCU villains to actually succeed in their plans.
You should have gone for the head.
While wiping out half of existence everywhere for 5 years is impressively terrifying, it isn't just this that makes Thanos interesting. The best villains have motives we can understand. Thanos' desire came from wanting to help the universe in the long run, as it has finite resources he thought were depleting too quickly.
With all 6 stones, I could simply snap my fingers. They would all cease to exist. I call that mercy.
And then what?
I finally rest.
This is a much more intriguing motivation than simply wanting to impress Lady Death, as he does in the Infinity Gauntlet comic storyline. Thanos' usually calm composure, his violent acts, and his firm belief that what he's doing is right make him one of the best MCU villains.
I am inevitable.
Number 9, Wanda Maximoff. There are several MCU characters defined by trauma, and Wanda Maximoff, aka the Scarlet Witch, has suffered more than most.
You took everything from me.
I don't even know who you are.
You will.
Her parents, her brother, and Vision have all perished. However, seeing how Wanda has persisted and carried on has made her a character easy to root for. Even when she did go all murder happy across 2 universes, we couldn't help but cheer her on.
I would never hurt you. Never. I would never hurt anyone. I'm not a monster.
Not only that, but her immense power levels that seemingly haven't even begun to peak have led to some wonderfully thrilling sequences. Even that has tied in with her struggles. The mantle of Scarlet Witch is a heavy weight to bear, leading her to make some mistakes and others to view her as a monster.
It's your destiny to destroy the world.
I'm not what you say I am.
Oh, really?
Number 8, Doctor Strange. Once a highly skilled surgeon, it took a horrific car accident to put Stephen Strange on the right path.
Why are you doing this to me?
To show you just how much you don't know. Open your eyes.
Since then, we've marveled at every new bit of magic he's wielded against world conquerors and interdimensional beings alike. Part of the fun of Doctor Strange is seeing what clever ruse or trick he'll come up with next.
And this stone may be the best chance we have against Thanos.
Yeah, so conversely, it may also be his best chance against us.
Well, if we don't do our jobs.
What is your job exactly besides making balloon animals?
Protecting your reality, douchebag.
But we also love that he's not afraid to rub anyone the wrong way, even if he is working with them to save the world or the multiverse. Although it took an accident for him to change some of his ways, he has never lost the extreme ambition that we find so admirable. Whether he's the Sorcerer Supreme or not, we'll always be a Supreme fan of his.
Wait, I thought you were the Sorcerer Supreme.
No, he got it on a technicality because I blipped for 5 years.
Oh, well, congratulations.
If I'd been here, then I
would burn the place down.
Number 7, Natasha Romanoff. The first Marvel heroine movie audiences were introduced to, Natasha Romanoff quickly became one of the more mysterious characters in the MCU.
I want you to meet Agent Romanoff.
Hi.
I'm a S.H.I.E.L.D. Shadow. Once we knew you were ill, I was tasked to you by Director Fury.
Part of that was due to Marvel not giving her a movie until far too late. But even still, everything about the super spy immediately made us want to know more. Natasha began as a great buffer between the larger-than-life heroes, before becoming a steadfast ally to Captain America.
Who do you want me to be?
How about a friend?
Well, there's a chance you might be in the wrong business, Rogers.
Throughout the franchise, we got pieces of her past, painting her as a deeply regretful character trying to make up for past wrongdoings. With an intriguing past and a ton of awesome spy skills, we loved seeing her hang with the guys and kick plenty of bad guy butt. Number 6, Thor. The God of Thunder has had one of the most chaotic arcs in the MCU. He began as a stubborn deity who preferred to let his hammer do the talking.
Run back home, little princess.
Dad.
Next.
And while he still loves a good smiting, he's gone through some hard-learned lessons. He's lost many loved ones, including most of his best friends and family members.
Families can be tough.
Before my father died, he told me that I had a half-sister that he imprisoned in hell. Then she returned home and stabbed me in the eye, so I had to kill her.
That's life that was nice.
However, he will never stop fighting for what is right. Ragnarok was a wonderful turning point, tapping into the goldmine that is Chris Hemsworth's comedic timing.
I prefer you.
Thanks.
But if I'm being honest, when it comes to fighting evil beings, he is very powerful and useful.
Yeah, Banner's powerful and useful too.
Is he though?
Infinity War and Endgame took him through depression and guilt, while we in the audience cheered him on through every low point.
Now I know that guy might scare you.
Why would I be? Why would I be scared of that guy? I'm the one who killed that guy, remember?
Thor is a powerhouse, but he's also a great character. Number 5, T'Challa. Though Chadwick Boseman's time in the MCU was tragically short, we're grateful he was able to portray one of its best characters.
My king.
Stop it.
The King of Wakanda is a symbol not just for his citizens, but for many African-American viewers who wanted to see themselves represented on screen. Never failed to captivate audiences, whether through his thirst for vengeance in Civil War or his journey in Black Panther, where he learned his kingdom was far from perfect.
All of you are wrong! To turn your backs on the rest of the world! We let the fear of our discovery stop us from doing what is right.
He's been shown to be calm and respectful when it counts, but also powerful and unwavering in the face of injustice and villainy. Upholding everything that makes a great king, his grace will truly be missed. Number 4, Loki. Like many of you, we were obsessed with Tom Hiddleston's Loki the moment he appeared on screen.
If it's any consolation, I think you're right. About the Frost Giants, about Laufey, about everything. If they found a way to penetrate Asgard's defenses once, who's to say they won't try again?
Beginning as a dastardly and treacherous brother to Thor, Loki's path to redemption has been one of the most genuine pleasures in the long-running series. Though, let's face it, most of the time, he's still a little troll not to be trusted. Even when he was outright murdering people, we couldn't help but be charmed by him.
Last time I saw you, you were trying to kill everybody. Where are you at these days?
It varies from moment to moment.
Charismatic and mischievous, Loki heightens every scene he appears in. He could have easily just been maniacal and bloodthirsty, but underneath that was something more. It just took a lot of failed grasps at power for him to realize it.
If it's all the same to you, I'll have that drink now.
Whatever the future holds for Loki, we can't wait to see it. Number 3, Peter Parker. Peter Parker may be the easiest MCU hero to like. Tom Holland has managed to capture both the dorky humor and social awkwardness that made us love Peter for years.
Probably stop staring before he gets creepy, though.
Too late. You guys are losers.
But then why do you sit with us?
Because I don't have any friends.
We knew that from only a handful of scenes in Civil War, and every other subsequent appearance has been an honest delight.
Yeah, we don't really need to start a conversation.
Okay. Captain?
Though he's made several decisions without thinking, as any teenager with superpowers would, those decisions have all come from a mindset of wanting to do what is right. He's had to learn harsh truths about sacrifice and loss more times than any teen should. So he's also the hero we'd most like to give a hug. Despite it all, Peter's resilience shows he is braver and more capable than many others. Number 2, Steve Rogers. When it comes down to it, there's nothing about Steve Rogers we don't respect. Despite his stature, he worked tirelessly to fight for his country in World War II before he knew it was right.
Get away! Get back!
Since then, his moral compass has never steered him wrong, a fact we're all probably a little jealous of.
I can do this all day.
Yeah, I know.
Whether it be his own teammates, an army of robots, or just good old-fashioned aliens, Steve was always there to defend those who couldn't defend themselves and stand up for justice, even when he was alone. It doesn't hurt that he's also an excellent strategist, combatant, and has an immovable sense of honor. No wonder he was able to wield Mjolnir. Before we unveil our top pick, here are some honorable mentions. Wong, a steadfast ally and wonderful Sorcerer Supreme.
It's not real. It's a fairy tale. It doesn't exist.
Actually, it does. I found out in the secret book you get when you become Sorcerer Supreme.
Unbelievable.
Peggy Carter. She's much more than Captain America's main squeeze.
A gas leak? Well, no injuries, I hope.
You're not from around here, are you?
No, I live in Brooklyn, actually.
Matt Murdock. Charlie Cox and Netflix excellently showcased his moral struggles.
I'm gonna kill you!
Take your shot.
Rocket. Violent, hilarious, and the best member of the Guardians.
How much for the gun?
Not for sale.
Okay, how much for the arm?
Oh, I'll get that arm.
Scott Lang. A goofy thief with a heart of gold.
I think you look great, Cap. As far as I'm concerned, that's America's ass.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1. Trevor Slattery. One of the MCU's best twists came at the courtesy of its biggest breakout character.
They gave me things. They gave me this palace. They gave me plastic surgery. They gave me things.
Only kidding. You know who number one is. Number one, Tony Stark. There are many reasons Iron Man remains one of the MCU's strongest solo outings, though chief among them is Tony Stark.
Truth is, I am Iron Man.
Captured perfectly by Robert Downey Jr., Tony began his superhero career as a selfish, rich jerk. But seeing the pain his work caused had an extremely positive effect on him. We're not saying he doesn't have any flaws. He's got more than he knows what to do with, and has created more than his fair share of villains.
There's no politics here, it's just good old-fashioned revenge. There's no Pentagon, it's just you and me. And on the off chance you're a man, here's my home address.
But his actions were always born out of a desire to protect Earth. His flaws only served to give him more depth and to make him more fascinating.
That's not a hug, I'm just grabbing the door for you. We're not there yet.
Tony's journey from self-absorbed to self-sacrifice will always be one of the strongest arcs of the MCU.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.